Good morning, engineering students. So, I hope that you have completed your work, previous work. That was that you have to write the factors and its properties. So, after completing this, now today we will start the checkpoint. So, for that, you need to take out page number 44 in your book. First, we will do question number 8 in the book, and then we will be doing question number B in notebook, right? So take out your textbook and notebook both and be ready for the class. Okay, students, now let's start the class. First of all of you take out page number 44. It is on the page number 44. All of you take out and write their date. That is 9/07/2020. Write down the date in your book. Now, fast. Now, I am going to say the question and you have to tell me the answers, right? So now, what is the first question? First fill in the blank says, question number 1, use pencil to write in the book. No need to use pen, okay? Dash is the factor of all number. Now tell me, yesterday I have already discussed this. Tell me the answer. Yes. 1 is a factor of all number. So if you want, you can write 1 like this or like this. It's your wish. Okay. Write 1 is a factor of all numbers. Now next is 2 is a factor of all dash numbers. Now tell me. 2 is a factor of all, even or odd? What will be the answer? 2 is a factor of all even numbers. So right here, even numbers. The smallest factor of 14 is, the smallest factor of 14 will be 1 or 14? Yes, the smallest factor of 14 is 1. Factor is 1. And if we talk about multiple, then it will be 14. Okay. Now, after that, the fourth question. 6 is a factor of 18, as 18 can be divided by dash exactly. So, 6 is a factor of 18, as 18 can be divided by which number? It can be divided by 6 exactly. So we will write here 6. Write down. And you have to understand also all these things. Now next is, all numbers except 1 has at least how many factors? 1 is a unique number. It has only 1 factor. But other numbers have at least 2 factor. What are they? 1 and the number itself. So write here 2. At least 2 factors. Now complete it in your books. After completing, pick up your notebooks and then we will be doing question number B of this checkpoint in your notebooks first. Take out and write down the heading. Question number B, list all the factors of each of the following. Note down the heading. Okay, so now let's proceed. First, what you have to do? Mention the date. So what is the date? It's 9/07/2020. Write down and write down this heading in a new page where you have written properties. After that, in the next page, note down this question. Question number B. List all the factors of each of the following. And note down question number 1, that is 18. Now, question will be with the black pen as discussed, and solution with the blue pen. Okay. So now, how to find factors? I will be telling you the 2 methods to find out the factors. Whatever you feel like, whichever is easy for you, you can use that. But when in your exam it is mentioned that you have to use this method particularly, then you have to use that method. Otherwise, you can use any method. It's your choice. Okay, so let's start. First method is that which we were doing yesterday. So now, first of all, we will start with table of 1. So 1 multiplied by 18 is 18, right? Now 18 comes in table of 2. Yes or no? Yes. So we will write here 2. 2 multiplied by 9 is equals to 18. Now it comes in table of 3 also. So next, 3 multiplied by 6 is equals to 18. Got it? So now, do it comes in table of 4? No. Then 5? No. And 6 we have already got here. So we got all the factors, right? So let's write the answer. So the answer is 1, 2, 3, 6, 9, and 18. Are all the factors of 18. Done. This is the first method. Now I will be telling you the second method. You can opt any method, it's your wish. See here, you can do circle like this so that you don't leave any answer. It's important that you have to write all the factors. Okay, if you will leave any of them, then your marks will be deducted. So you be careful. Okay, now coming to the second method. Second method is called prime factorization method. Now how to do it? See here, first we will draw a line. You have to use scale for that. Now write 18 here. Now what we have to do is, always remember, when we are doing prime factorization method, we always start from the smallest number, that is 2. So if our number is dividing from 2, so always we have to start with 2. Otherwise then we can proceed then 3, 4, likewise. But still 18 is divisible by 2, exactly divisible, so we will start with 2. So how many times? If we divide from 2, then how many times it will go? 9 times. So now see here, 2 multiplied by 9 is 18. So we have divided here. Now again we will draw a line. Now 9 is divisible by 2. No. Then what we have to do? We will check the next table, that is 3. In table of 3, 9 is there, right? So 3 times is 9. 3 threes are 9. Done? Now, 3 is there. We have to find out up until and unless we get here 1. Okay? We have to find out until and unless we get here 1. Okay? So now, You don't have to make the circle. Okay. So now we got the answer here, 1. Now see how to find out the factors. Now see here, the factors which we have written in answer. 1 is already there. 2 we have got here. Then 3. Then 6. How we got the 6? We multiplied these two numbers. 2 threes are 6. Then here we have 3 multiplied by 3. 3 threes are 9. So we have written here. And we got all these numbers here also. So in this way we can find out with using prime factorization method. This is prime factorization method. And this also you have to learn. I know you must be liking the first method, but you have to learn the second method also. Both methods are important. You have to prepare for both. So now note it down. Note it down. And then I will explain you the next question. Do it. I hope that you have understood the first and the second method. You can write here or. When the method is not mentioned, you can opt any method. But when method is mentioned, you have to opt that method only. Okay. Now after doing this, let's move to the next question. Okay. So now. Now the next question is 28. We have to find the all the factors of 28. So now start. Here also I will be doing both the method so that you can be habitual of both the methods. Okay. So first I am doing the first method. And then here I will be doing the second method. And you also note down both the method. And then I will give you the homework. Then you can opt any of those. It's your wish. Now see here, the number is 28. Okay. So now, we will always start with 1. Because 1 is factor of each and every number. So now we have multiplied and we got 28. 1 multiplied by 28 is 28. Next, 28 comes in table of 2. So let's start. 2 multiplied by 14 is equals to 28. Then, do 28 comes in table of 3? No. Then in 4? Yes. So 4 multiplied by 7 is equals to 28. Done. So now how many factors we have got? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, right? So now tell me 28 comes in table of 5? No. 6? No. Then 7. So we got all the 6 factors here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Got it? So now let's write the answer here. 1 comma 2, 4, then comma 7, comma 14 and 28 are the factors of 28. Got it? So now, prime factorization method we will be doing. So now, here it is 28. So always we have to start with 28. Here is 28. So we will write first 28 and then we will start dividing it by 2. So how many times it is divisible? 2. 1 is 2. Then 2. 4s are 8. So we got here 14. What we are doing actually, let me tell you so that you won't be confused. I'm using this as a rough part. No need to do it. This is my rough part. Okay. Now what I'm doing? This is 28. I'm dividing 28 by 2. So how many times it is going? 2. 1 is 2. Then we got here 0. Then what we will write here? 8. 2. 4s are 8. So what we are getting? 0. So the number, if it is exactly divisible and the question which we are getting, we are writing the question here. Understood? So that what we are doing. So now don't be confused. Now let's do it. Now after dividing, then 14 is exactly divisible by 2. You can check here. 2 7s are 14. 2 7s are 14. So what we are getting here? 0. So now 7 is question and we are dividing by 2. So we will write 2 here and the question always we have to write here. Now 7 is a number. It's a odd number and it is only divisible by itself. So what we have to write here? 7. How many times? 1. We have to divide until and unless we are getting here 1. Got it? So now I am erasing the rough part and you all note down the question and solution. Past. Note it down, students. Now check that we have got all the factors or not. See here, 1 is a factor, then 2 is a factor, and then 2 multiplied by 2, 4 is a factor. You can see here, 1 done, 2 done, 4 done, then 7 here, and then 7 multiplied by 2, that is 14, and then the main number. See, we got all these numbers, right? So now note it down. If you want, you can show this multiplication sign. Otherwise, it's not required, but it's your wish. Okay, do it and write or. After doing question number 2, we will be proceeding towards question number 3. Done, students. Okay, after doing this, if you need one page for each question, then do the next question in the next page. And if you have space, you can continue from there only. Okay, Now moving towards the next question, that is 36. Again, we will be doing both method. Okay, so first method, even you can try by your own, you can start doing by your own. And fourth and fifth, that is 21 and 35, is your homework. Okay, and you can do in the same copy, and if you have made two copies, one for classwork, one for homework, so you can do the homework in the next copy, or else you can continue in this only. So now let's start the finding out the factors of 36. So let's start. 36 is a number we will always start with. 1. 1 multiplied by 36 is 36. Now tell me, is it divisible by 2? Exactly, yes. 2, how many times? 2 multiplied by 18 is equals to 36. Now 36 comes in table of 3, yes or no? Yes. 3 multiplied by 12 is equals to 36, right? Then 36 comes in table of 4? Yes, it comes. 4 multiplied by 9 times is 36. Then do it comes in table of 5? No. Then in 6, 6 are 36. We got it? We got how many factors? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. Total how many factors we have pointed out? 9 factors. As there is 6 two times, so, but we have to write only one time. Okay. Now let's write the answer. 1, 2, then 3, 4, 6, 9, 12, 18, 36, 36 are the factors of 36. This is the first method. Now moving towards the second method. So let's find out. First we will write 36. And then remember, always we have to start with 2. So now that's a rough part. Got it? Now you can check 36 is exactly divisible by 2, right? 2 ones are 2. Then here 1 is left. Then we will write 6. 2 8s are 16. So now we got the question. So how many times? 18 times, right? Then again 18 is divisible by 2, right? How many times? 2. How many times? 9 times. 9 multiplied by 2 is 18. Now is it going by 2? No. Then what we have to write? It will go by 3 times. And then 3, 3's are 9. Done. Now 3 is left. It will go by 3. 3, 1's are 3. So now we have got all the factors here. Now let me erase the rough part and you all note down the question. Pass to the solution. Now see, we have got 1, 2, 3, 2 multiplied by 2, 4, then 3 multiplied by 2, 6, then 9, then here, 2 multiplied by 2 is 4, Then 4 multiplied by 3 is 12. So we have to multiply 4. We got 12, then 18, then 36. In this way we have done. Okay. So now note it down. Do it. After completing this, I will be giving you the homework. So complete the work fast. Note down both the methods. And this stick part and the circle is not required. I am going to explain you, so you can leave that part, okay? It's not required. I am just doing for your comfortability so that you can understand. I hope that you have completed this. So now, your today's homework. Note down, students, this is your today's homework. You have to find out all the factors of 21 and 35. Try to opt both the methods so that it will be easy for you. Note down both the questions, that is 4th number is 21 and 5th number is 35. These two questions you have to do as a homework. You can do in the same notebook, or else if you have made the homework notebook another one, so you can continue in that copy. I don't have problem with that. So just do the homework properly, and if you have faced any problem, please discuss with me, and I will be solving this answers also in the next class. I will tell you the explanation, but try to solve by your own. Okay, students? And try both methods so that it will be good for you that you know all the methods, right? So, note it down the homework. This is 21 and 35 only, these two questions. So, thank you, students. That's all for today. And tomorrow we will be studying the divisibility rules. Okay? So, till then, take care. Bye-bye. Stay safe and stay home. Take care, students. Use mask and sanitizer. Please take care of yourself. Take care, students. Bye.